got you guys set up on a tripod inside the cab, so we'll see how this works. Sorry if it's going to be all bouncy, but... jump out and cut these limbs off real quick. Set you up so you guys can see. I'm gonna cut the few limbs off and top it real quick. So these cedars are, one of my friends, his company he works for, they have this field they're clearing out for a customer, so they were just gonna, they pushed them over with the high lift, and if I didn't take them, they're just gonna burn them. Anytime I get free cedar, it's pretty good deal. So I'm not measuring anything out. This is kind of a rush here. Traco is leaving after today. This is Sunday today. Sunday morning. All this out of here for as much as we can today. I got a friend brought me a load of it yesterday, so busy cutting. Busy cutting logs yesterday on the sawmill, so I wasn't able to be out here helping. That's my dad. He's out here helping me today. Me and him are trying to get as much as we cut, or as much cut as we possibly can. Gosh, this tripod is not working. Yep. shut you guys off and maybe set you up outside.
Thank you.
with the orange on them back here, the ones that were brought to me. And then all the other ones from here forward. And all these ones here, the ones me and my dad got yesterday. This is actually Monday now. So that's what we did yesterday. These logs, they're pretty decent. There's some like that one there. I don't know what I'm going to be able to get out of it. And it's pretty dang crooked too. I don't know what I'm going to be able to get out of it. But I'd rather have it than not have it, I guess. Because I can always use it for something eventually. Even if it's going to sit here for... might only sit here for a couple days. It might sit here for a month. I don't know. But yeah. I'd rather have it than not have it. Especially if it's just going to get left behind and get burned, essentially. So might as well take it. And there... I think... the field... I guess it was just a field. An overgrown field. So all the logs have a ton of branches on them, which is not the best thing. Like, here's an example. That's what field cedars look like, basically, around here and then back here. I'll show you what wood cedars look like from around here. These are actually these little ones in the front here, we got two yesterday. But yeah, this is a log that would be in the woods here. It has not very many branches on it, especially towards the bottom. It doesn't have hardly any branches. And then towards the top, they'll fill out with branches. But yeah. So that's woods. Cedar that's grown in the thick woods. And then this is cedar that's grown in the fields, overgrown fields, basically. They get the real deep cuffs on them. They have tons of branches everywhere. They're not the highest quality. They got a lot of white in them, as you can see. And again, there's another comparison. Look at all the white in them, and then look how much white is in this, like in the cedar that's grown in the woods. So that's woods, and then that's field. So there's a big difference in that. I'm not as concerned about the white as I am about the deep cuffs in the branches. When they have them deep cuffs and branches, it makes it real difficult. Not difficult, but it'll make it really tricky getting lumber out of it. You really gotta pay attention to every board you cut off, every board you pull off, to see how deep the cuffs are running and where they're running. See if you can make a cut to get to cut the cuffs out or the deep seams or whatever. but yeah, it's a little bit slow of a process. Hopefully with these ones, I'll be cutting mostly 6x6s with them. When they have the cuffs in the 6x6s, it's not as big of a deal because there's so much wood there holding the beam together. It doesn't make that much of a deal. Now, if I was cutting these into like half inch thick boards and there's a cuff running down cuff seam, whatever you want to call it, running down the middle of the board is almost guaranteed it's going to just fall apart or break in half along that seam. So hopefully we'll cut these into, like I said, 4x4s or 6x6s, or we might even get a couple 8x8s for a guy that I'm talking to now. So we'll see. Hopefully we can get good lumber out of them. But we shall see. We're getting a bunch of cedar here lined up again. That's all stuff I cut the other couple weeks ago. Well, actually last week. During the week after work, I go to a guy's house and I cut everything, and he sits on the tractor and loads them for me and pulls them out of the woods. So that always works out really good when I can have a deal like that. So hope you guys have a good evening. Enjoy yourselves and take care. Thank you.